What's up, everybody? Welcome to Podcast Now. I'm Alex, and I'm here today to give my tips and tricks for Sea of Thieves. So this video is going to be discussing some of the major things you should know going into Sea of Thieves. Now, some of them may be considered tips and tricks. You can also kind of consider this a beginner's guide, stuff that you should know getting into the game. So we're going to be talking about different aspects of the game and going from there up. If there's any tips and tricks that you guys can think of or that you want to add, put them in the comments below. Help everybody out that comes to this video. And again, if you're here for the giveaway, we're giving away Sea of Thieves, actually. If you're here, if you know somebody who wants the game but doesn't have it, definitely tell them that we're giving away the game and have them check out our video on that. Okay, so Sea of Thieves, the game is finally out, thank God, because I've been waiting for this game for a long time. Well, let's start out by talking about sailing. So sailing is obviously one of the major things you're going to be doing in this game. Obviously, it gets you from point A to point B, and the ship is a huge, huge mechanic and huge, huge part of this game. When sailing, the first thing you're probably going to want to do is play this game with more than one person, more than yourself. Not exactly a tip and trick, but what I've been reading and kind of just seeing, it generally seems like this game is nowhere near as fun if you play by yourself. You need to be playing with a group of people you know, or just anybody in particular, but having crewmates is very, very important. And it's important, especially in the aspect of sailing. There's a couple things you need to keep in mind when sailing. There's dropping the anchor, there's navigation, there's turning the sails, and there's actually steering the ship in general. And so everybody can really have a job, and you're going to want to do that. You're going to want to diversify your roles and have one person doing one thing. You don't necessarily want one person to do three different jobs. It's just not going to work out. In terms of these sails, you're going to want to be able to catch the wind. Now, that may seem obvious, but you know, you're going to want to look for the wind patterns literally in the air. Turn your sails so they are facing that direction. If there's no other way of doing it, if the wind hits the sails and there's, you know, it's going in reverse, you want to turn your sails as far one way or the other as you possibly can, unless you can literally turn around and kind of go in a circle. Those are really the only two things you can do with that aspect. Another thing that I've been reading and seeing is the anchor. The anchor is incredibly, incredibly important, and important for kind of more reasons and used for more reasons than I actually thought. The anchor obviously is used for yourself first and foremost. You drop anchor, you know, when you're actually on your ship, when you're close to an island. Never try and steer your ship on an island. Don't park it like a car or any kind of vehicle like that. You want to kind of drop your anchor far enough away from an island where you don't risk your ship actually hitting it. But the anchor can be used for more than that. The anchor can be used to literally just stop your ship in combat. Maybe you want to make a really neat turn, or you just want to get out of a combat situation. You can use it. You can use it to make really quick pivots just while you're sailing in general. A thing that I was reading about, I haven't done it, but a thing I was reading about is actually something smart to do is fire somebody in your cannon to the other ship and have them drop anchor on that ship. And that's a really good way of just literally stopping your enemy in your trail. I thought that was a really, really good and kind of sly move. But obviously, sailing your ship is only part of it. There's going to be a lot of treasure. The whole point of this game is to get treasure, right? Get loot. So getting loot, again, this first aspect is kind of just a beginner's guide kind of thing, just a thing to know. You're going to be carrying loot a lot, and you're going to be finding loot a lot. The world is the same no matter where, what server, what game you're in. The islands are always going to be the same, but the quests and how you get to said treasure is going to be different each time. So there's always going to be a different way to get to it, but you are going to have to most of the time dig treasure up out of the ground, and you're going to have to carry it. You can jump, you can swim, you can climb ladders, you can do all that stuff while having the treasure in your hand. But the treasure is very important. Just because you have it doesn't mean you actually have it. You need to turn it into a vendor in order to get any points, any kind of money, and it would be split if you have a crew. It would be split evenly, but that treasure can be taken from you, and so it's important to be able to hide said treasure and be able to kind of store it away on your ship. Most players will probably put it on the very bottom level of the ship. That oftentimes is the first one to sink when your ship gets attacked, and that's also a thing, you know, kind of going ahead a little bit into resources. You know, there's pistols, there's swords, there's bananas. Bananas are for health, but there's also, you know, wooden planks that you use to patch up your ship. You're going to want to have these things. You're going to want to have cannonballs so you can actually get yourself out of a fight or start a fight if you're that kind of person. But you're going to want to protect your ship, and because especially if a person or another pirate attacks your ship, that bottom level is the first one to go. You can actually hide your treasure in your ship. You can disguise it. You can kind of blend it in with other treasures. You can kind of store it in hard to find places. That's a good idea because, again, You don't get anything for that treasure until you turn it in. And so during that time that you have it, anything can happen. If that treasure falls in the water, you have a couple seconds to retrieve it. Otherwise, it's gone. It disappears. So it's very important to protect that treasure with your life. A couple other quick notes. These are, again, kind of things you should know going into the game, is the environment is dangerous. I mean, you have to be aware of wind patterns. You have to be aware of the kind of the current. You can sail into territories you shouldn't be in. You can sail where there's sharks and you can get killed by sharks. The Kraken does officially exist. People have found it. I think, you know, that was a thing that people had really known from the beginning, or at least was hoping the Kraken would be in. But the Kraken exists. There's a lot of things in this world that can actually kill you. And there's things on land too, such as snakes. So you're not even safe when you're on land. However, another thing, you know, just to casually note, if you fall off your ship and you're in the water for too long, you'll know that a mermaid comes up in the water, and you go to that mermaid and it transports you back to the ship. Now, when you die, you kind of get put in like a you know, a Davy Jones kind of locker, like a ship sailing into limbo, which I think is really, really cool, by the way. But that is just kind of, you know, the stasis period. You have to go through the door eventually when it opens, and you'll be back to where you were. And the last couple things, again, with the treasure, you do not get the treasure until you bring it in, but the game does not autosave. If you quit when you have the treasure but you didn't turn in, you'll lose it. So, you know, turning things in, going back to the quest giver, is very, very important. And that's pretty much all I have for my basic tips and tricks for this game. As the week progresses, we're going to have more stuff. We may have a fighting guide, whether it be, you know, sword combat or whether it be ship combat. I'm thinking about possibly doing one or both. We're going to be having a review later on in the week, but stay tuned to the channel. We have a lot more Sea of Thieves stuff coming. Again, we're giving away the game as well. So if you know somebody who wants the game, definitely check that video out. Have them. Maybe they can win. They can play with you. Thank you guys so much for watching. Leave in the comments any tips and tricks you'd give people, and I will see you on the next Sea of Thieves video.